In economic and urban development, innovation districts have become a hot topic. Typically located in cities, these alluring live and work playgrounds concentrate actors, amenities, and resources to provide an environment conducive to innovation. Inspired by seeming successes in Boston and Barcelona, economic developers and policymakers promote innovation districts as a mechanism for generating entrepreneurship, job growth, and urban redevelopment. But are innovation districts an effective way to produce innovative and dynamic economies? Are they really able to achieve the vision of sustainable urban revitalization that its proponents are touting? Or are they just a fad? To answer these questions, we talked with the creators of four innovation districts and the entrepreneurs embedded within them. Because these four innovation districts are spread across the United States, they present different backgrounds and trajectories. These contrasts enabled us to hone in on some of the key factors that determine an innovation district's outcomes. We found that while innovation districts have important advantages, they are not suitable for all places. In fact, they may be a waste of resources or even displace existing residents. In order to make innovation districts work, it is crucial to know that one size does not fit all. An innovation district's policies and strategies and physical extent should suit the needs and characteristics of the region in which they are rooted. Leadership is crucial. Successful innovation districts are based upon a coherent vision, have active champions, and are supported by the key players in the regional economy. Context matters. Innovation districts cannot develop independently of the economic strengths of their region. Active support from anchor institutions is important, but may not be necessary in places with an already established entrepreneurial ecosystem. Find the right site. An innovation district should be located where it makes sound economic sense, not just where politicians or other elites favor real estate development. Innovation districts aimed at stimulating growth where it is already strong could lead to negative consequences, such as surging costs and dislocated entrepreneurs. Former industrial zones are often a good choice because they offer readily convertible spaces capable of hosting suitable densities in areas convenient to urban amenities. Diversity is necessary. Innovation districts thrive by offering space for businesses of different sizes and residents from various walks of life. If not protected, a successful innovation district can displace the businesses and people that once made it a vibrant environment for innovation. For more information, visit our report with detailed analyses and findings.